his counsel suggests. Because why? Because Mr. Williamson is here on the couch, right?
Correct.
That's right. So that's not that valid. So why don't we get him on here? That's all I want to do is ask him some questions since he's the one on the leaves. So bring him on over. Let me get him under oath. That's okay. Mr. Williamson, come on over.
Yes, sir. How are you doing, Your Honor?
It's all right. I'm used to dealing with pro se people. Raise your right hand for me.
Absolutely.
Raise your right. You swear or affirm to tell the truth, the whole truth, under penalty and perjury of the law?
See.
Is that a yes? Brother, come on. You can't say yeah, maybe, no. Yes, yes or no?
Come on.
Is that a yes? All right. Excellent. Put your hand.
Yes.
Turn your camera on, Ms. Williamson. Williamson.
Yes.
All
yes,
right.
Your Honor.
And counsel, do you guys have any witnesses or is it just you?
Yes, Your Honor. Ms. Muhammad is here. Again, before you swear in the person who's claiming to be Ms. Williamson, she's not a tenant. She's not living at the property. She is practicing the unlicensed practice of law by trying to represent her son and other people who live there. I would ask that she not be sworn in, that she not be allowed to argue and advocate on behalf of people because she's not a lawyer. She's not an agent. She doesn't have any sort of order from a probate court saying that these other people are incompetent to allow her to be here today and to just speak on behalf of people. She's not a party to the case. That would be improper. It would be the unlicensed practice of law. And we would ask that she be removed from the room and not be allowed to be sworn in or testify or speak at all.
I appreciate
Your Honor,
that.
Can I say something to that, please? Because that is not true.
One, I haven't gotten you sworn in. Two,
okay.
I'm sworn in. Counsel will confine all of that out, and I can determine whether or not she has the appropriate relationship to this particular home to be able to make an argument, because it is all others. And if it isn't, then it's fine. We strike whatever and go from there. But I'm not going to do that before I find out information. Just take it purely on your word. Counsel can't do that. So let me go ahead and get you under oath, Ms. Williamson.
Thank
you. Swear or affirm to tell the truth, the whole truth, and the penalty and perjury of the law?
Yes.
All right, counsel, why don't you just tell me now that she's under oath. I don't know where's Ms. Muhammad, so I can get her under oath as well, just in case.
Ms. Muhammad.
Your Honor, I'm here.
Where are you, ma'am? I'm searching for you.
Ms. Muhammad, your camera.
My laptop has a cracked screen and it's going directly across the top. I don't have a problem signing in from my phone, if you would prefer that.
I would.
My video is on.
Yeah, I can't see you though. That makes no value to the court if I can't see you.
Yes, Your Honor.
Mediator Gris, did you have an announcement? All right, Ms. Muhammad, go ahead. Raise your right hand. You can actually log out the other device. Where are you, Ms. Muhammad? Go ahead and turn your camera on and mute.
I'm here.
Oh. Raise that right hand for me. You swear or affirm to tell the truth, the whole truth, and a penalty and perjury of the law?
I do.
Excellent. All right, counsel, tell me. Well, I'm going to ask you a couple of questions rather than it'll be easier if I do so. Tell me, is this a written or oral lease that you have with Delandez Williamson, or do they have any relationship at all with this Miss Williams? Can Miss Williams go ahead and turn her camera on for me and unmute? I mean, and turn her camera on. Miss Williamson.
Yes,
where's Williamson? I think Williams is playing games.
There I go, Your Honor. Sorry.
Don't play. All right, hold tight. Counsel, does she have any, or is this a written or oral lease with the named defendant?
So this is a written lease between my client, Ms. Muhammad, and the two tenants that were listed on the property were Delandez Williamson, who is the gentleman sitting on the couch, and Lateria Williams, who I have not seen her call in. She may be in the room, I don't know, but I've not seen her. And that was signed back in, I believe it was December 31st of 2022. The term was to start February 1st of 2023 and end June 1st, 2023. Mm-hmm. It has a provision in there that says that if After the term, if they have agreed to remain on, it becomes at will under the same terms of the lease agreement. So that's what happened. It was $2,000 a month. They remained on the property. Unbeknownst to us, we believe that there was an unauthorized subtenant that was put, that was allowed on the property, which is why my client named all others, right? Because we believe there's maybe somebody else who's living there through a sublease that we didn't know about. However, no rent has been paid since November. So no. it was 2000 a month.
So you slow it down for me. Is there a late fee associated with this matter?
Yes. Yeah, so under the lease, it's $100 per occurrence after the fifth day. So that's out of 2000, that's 5%.
It maxes out at $200. As you know, I stated that earlier, counsel. So you've got no payment since November. Was that payment in full in November or was that partial payment?
There was full payment in November, no rent in December,
January, February, March,
and now April. So 5 months, so around $10,000. And then a demand for possession was made in December to terminate the tenancy at will. However, my client put 30 days on there. So when she did her first eviction action, the judge completely didn't look at the non-payment of rent piece and only said you had to give 60 days. True. And said, come back, right? After the 60 days waits up, come back. You've sent the notice already. It's just 60 days will have passed. And if they're still there and they haven't left, then we'll see what happens. And so here we are. My client also on March 4th sent a notice to vacate demand for rent, right? Under the other statute that says if they don't pay rent, you send a notice demand to vacate. That was ignored. So again, people are just living in the house. This case was filed. It was served on, I believe it was March 18th.
It's
cool.
It's all right, counsel. Hold tight. I just want to. I see that it was because the case was filed on the. Well, that's not sure. Hold on.
Had it filed March 12th and served on the 18th.
That's fine. That's fine. All right. Let me speak to this. Now, ma'am, you're Miss William. Now, what's your, can you unmute yourself? I'm fine.
She's
right.
Yes, sir.
What's your name?
My name is Charlita Williamson. On the actual lease, I'm the one that signed my son's name. He was incarcerated. He was incarcerated.
Miss Williamson. Hold time.
I'm sorry.
I'm going to ask you a couple
questions.
Sir. Oh, good. It's all right.
Okay.
So do you live there?
I did live there because I was going through a divorce, in there.
Ms. Williamson, I'm asking a present question. Do you live there? Not did you live there? Do you live there?
If you go with present, yes. No one is in there right now because the house caught on fire, the kitchen.
Okay.
So it's not.
So when's the last time you lived there?
On March 18th, when the notice was served.
Oh, you lived there on March 18th. Do you have
any
other property that you live in?
Next door. I live next door. My wife, that's what I'm stating. My wife
so
and
you're,
I.
You're right. I'm just listen. You listen. I'm not here. I'm on nobody's side. I'm on the law side. You don't need to try to convert things to fit. I'm just asking questions. You don't live there.
All right.
You're Mr. Williamson's mother. Is that correct?
Yes. But on the 18th, what I'm stating is for 2 weeks, I was there. Living
I don't think I don't think that makes you necessarily a tenant, but that's okay. That doesn't mean the case gets dismissed as counsel suggests. Because why? Because Mr. Williamson is here on the couch, right?
Correct.
That's right. So that's not that valid. So why don't we get him on here? That's all I want to do is ask him some questions since he's the one on the lease. So bring him on over. Let me get him under oath. That's okay. Mr. Williamson, come on over.
Yes, sir. How are you doing, Your Honor?
It's all right. I'm used to dealing with pro se people. Raise your right hand for me.
No, absolutely.
Raise your right. You swear or affirm to tell the truth, the whole truth, and a penalty and perjury of the law?
See.
Is that a yes? Brother, come on. You can't say yeah, maybe, no. Yes, yes or no? Is that a yes? All right. Excellent. Put your hand.
Yes.
Okay. Put your hand. All right. How much is monthly rent, Mr. Williamson? How much is monthly rent, Mr. Williamson?
$2,000.
Okay. Is there a late fee that you're aware of?
No.
Okay. And when's the last time you paid rent?
When was it? March. What was it? The 18th? Well, it
The
was.
last time you paid rent. So he heard me, Miss Williams. It's all right, Mom.
December.
So
December.
last time you paid rent.
December.
December what?
23 last year.
And was that for December rent or was that for a previous month's rent?
That was for December rent.
Okay. All right, so you're saying then that you have not paid rent for the months of January, February, or March, and they're saying you haven't paid rent rather for December. I'm sorry, December, January, February, March. You're saying 3 months, they're saying 4 months. Is that correct? Okay.
Yes.
All right. Beyond that, of course, if I gave a writ of possession, it would be 4 months and 9 days. But is there anything you want to let the court know before I go back to counsel here, as far as any defenses, any things you want to raise or you've raised in your answer, before I address the other side?
I never signed no lease, so that's why all I'm big on is just doing the ethical thing, you know, the law. I know there was a sublease with a tenant that was there, you know, but after that, that's where all of this came to occurrence, like the house, because I was the one who found that the house was up for foreclosure. So then that's when I so the a day later, that's when she called and basically tried to get more like
I see.
money or coerce a scheme to get money and then go do through an eviction. I just
Guys.
want the right ethical thing done. That's it.
Okay. All right. I think I gather what you're suggesting here. Counsel, there has not been a foreclosure on the property, has it? Just want to confirm.
No, Your Honor, my client was going through some tough financial times, and then when she stopped receiving rent from the tenants, that may have been worse. So she was forced to put it on the market to sell the property, so that she could avoid the foreclosure. It is under contract, and the sale has closed. However, there's a condition in it that she has to get the non-paying tenants out of the property, otherwise they can revoke the sale. And that she has to pay $2,800 a month for every month that they're not out of the property to the buyer.
I just want to confirm, counsel. So I don't, so
So
just so
there's
that
no
you know.
foreclosure.
No, not the foreclosure. You said there's a closing, but there hasn't been a recording of any deed, is what you're saying. Because if there's a recording of
I
a
don't know if
deed,
the deed has been recorded or not, but she's been given the contractual right from the contractual obligation from the buyer.
obligation or right. And I'm not trying to be difficult with you, but you're in front of a judge, so my mind starts thinking legally here. If does she not have ownership of the property anymore?
She doesn't.
Well, again, because she was the landlord under this, right? And her contract with them required her to take the action to have them removed, right? So she's acting on me with the authority under the contractual right of the owner. And also, Judge, even for this, right? Regardless, for purposes of this, if you wanted to have a trial, right, where we come in and we talk about whose ownership of the property and I bring in the buyer.
Attorney Brown, you know, I practice law when I'm not having this. We're on
Right.
call, so you don't got to be wrong.
Right. But
What I'm asking you, sir, is when did the sale take place?
don't. Oh, let me see if I can
House
find what
owned.
the closing
She
date
isn't the
was.
owner.
Just
Just hold on, Mr. Williams. I'm just asking, doing my due diligence here, not on nobody's side.
Ms. Williams, what was the date of closing recently?
Can someone tell me
I'm
that?
sorry. I'm sorry, Ms. Muhammad. What was the date of closing? Do you know?
It closed on March 5th, 2024.
March 5th.
March 5th has the deed been filed?
I'm unsure if the deed has been filed, Your Honor.
I'm not sure if
From
the deed's been filed either.
now,
But
counsel,
again, the
I'm not
contract that
listening.
I have.
But do you so just listen to me for a second. You may not agree with me. I just want you to hear my legal reasoning, just what I'm saying. If he no longer owns the property, They are no longer, because that contract is no longer in effect, because she's not an owner nor a landlord unless she has some type of an agency agreement specifically stating that she can proceed with these particular means, not saying she has a requirement to do so, but see, she has the legal ability to do so. You understand? Because once you lose possession or ownership of the property, you no longer have authority to make any demands or collect anything, maybe civilly, maybe on a sense of for past due rents, but not for writ of possession purposes, right? You can sue on a contract for that's past due, but not essentially to affect your rights as a landlord because you're no longer in possession, your owner no longer owns the property, right? It's the same thing when people get foreclosed on. Despite the fact that they may have an ability equitably to get the property back, that does not continue to allow them to possess the property after the fact. So what I'm
Your
saying.
Honor, I respectfully disagree, and because I have the contract that specifically grants her the authority and the obligation to go and bring the
Can you
action,
send, can, so this is what we'll do.
and
Like I
she is
suggesting that. Can,
in the same way that a property management company would go and bring
so
the
you
action
said
on behalf of the tenant.
you have paperwork that says that.
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes.
Okay, well, so do you did you already submit that to the in Odyssey?
So again, I got hired on Friday. It was Easter, and I've been sick yesterday. So
No,
I'm
so
happy to
listen.
send this over.
Oh, no,
And I can
listen,
show.
this is what we'll do. This is what we'll do because I really just want it done right. I have a short, this is a harder calendar to do when we have more in-depth trials because we have a bunch of virtual cases going on. I have an in-person calendar on the 9th. You understand that's next week, Tuesday. You go ahead and if you can provide me a copy of the contract showing that she still has the agency ability to pursue this eviction after the fact that this particular property is no longer in her possession or own, I'll allow the matter to continue to go forward. But obviously, just as a foreclosure happens, ultimately the authority with the person who get those other tenants out are the persons who now own the property, not the prior owner.
Well, let me ask you this, Judge. So OCGA 4479 specifically says the tenant is not permitted to dispute his landlord's title or attain to another claimant while he's in physical possession. If
If they lose it,
the
that's
defendants are going to raise that argument, they have to move out first. That's what 4479 says.
and I'm telling you that there's other law that I'm not going to tell you right now, but there's other law, and I'm not on their side, that effectively says if you're disputing the fact that the landlord is no longer has ownership of the property, you can make that argument. There's case law for that. I know that because I've raised it when I'm not having this robe on. So just bring me on next Tuesday what you have, and then it'll settle it. And then I can give immediate writ if I need to, right then and there.
Okay. So you're just gonna reset us for next Tuesday.
Reset for next Tuesday. Now,
Great.
if you're wrong, then you'll be you, the person who owns the property now is going to have to evict him.
Don't think I'm wrong, but if I am, I mean, that's pretty easy to fix too.
Of course, and all it takes is really an agency situation, but if you don't have it, obviously that would require something else new to be done. I'm just trying to make sure people follow the law, man. I know sometimes it hurts each side, but that's my job, following the law. So I will see you guys next Tuesday. I'm going to get my clerk to give you guys a reset notice here shortly, and we'll see you guys next Tuesday. Miss Williams, Mr. Williamson, as you understand, listen, I just want to be clear. This does not dispute the fact that you didn't owe them rent at some point, but if they've
No,
subsequently lost
absolutely.
ownership of
It's
the
about the ethical thing.
if they
Ethical
lost
thing.
ownership of the
They're not,
property,
they're
and
living,
that's
they're
the
not
law.
paying
That's the
rent.
law. So you're bigger than
Yeah.
that. If they
Can
not,
you prove? Can you show?
Miss Douglas, let folks, come on. I'll see you guys next Tuesday. I'll get you guys the notice. All right. Thank you.
Thank you, Judge.
Your Honor, is there any way we can get a copy of this evidence as well before court?
That's why, no, I don't know if you can get before court, but if there's a county record or anything like that, it should be submitted via Odyssey. But that's why I like to have folks come in person. We'll be able to see all that evidence at that time. All right. I'll see you guys
See you
there.
next Tuesday. Thank you.
Thank
Thank
you,
you.
counsel.
Thank you, Your Honor.
All right.